In this screencast, we're going to look at the different types of code completion in IntelliJ IDEA and see how and where to use them. We get code completion as soon as we start typing in IntelliJ IDEA. We don't always need to use a keyboard shortcut to bring up the suggestions. Suggestions are also context sensitive, so they should make sense for the current place we're typing. Simple things are completed for us, like closing braces. The basic completion dropdown suggests a wide range of things we might want to use in this position. We're going to select square for this example. We don't have to go back to the start of the line to declare our variable. We can press Alt and Enter and have IntelliJ IDEA create it for us. We even get useful defaults suggested for the variable names. Even as we're typing our variable declaration, IntelliJ IDEA will suggest types and names for us. When we're writing a string value, it will automatically insert a closing quote for us as well. To move outside of the string value, we can press Tab and type a semicolon to correctly finish off our line. But there's another trick we can use to automatically finish off lines. We can press Shift, Command and Enter on macOS, or Shift, Control and Enter on Windows, to complete the current statement. Let's create a list. Again, notice the brackets are closed for us, of strings. We can force the basic completion list to appear by pressing Control and Space. And here it shows us a list of suggested variable names given the type. Now let's try to use a variable. IntelliJ IDEA suggests a variable for us, and if we type a dot, we get the basic completion list of methods we could call. Methods directly on the class itself are in bold, and methods on the superclasses are displayed in a lighter font. This list is usually ordered with the most frequently used methods at the top. Let's change the return type of this method to a shape to demonstrate some other features of completion. Let's create another variable that's a circle. Square and circle both implement the shape interface. Now let's say we want to return something from this method. If we use basic completion, we have the variables we declared in this method at the top of the list, and quite a long list of options. But if we use smart completion, which is Control, Shift and Space, we're only given two options, which are the only two variables with the correct type for the return type of this method. Let's change the return type of this method to something even more restrictive. Now, when we use smart completion, IntelliJ IDEA simply automatically selects the only variable that is the correct type. We can use smart completion in a lot of different places, and it will always suggest something of the correct type. If we use it on the right-hand side of the list assignment, it suggests the collections factory methods that create lists that were introduced in Java 9. Let's change this to a list of squares. If we choose the square item from the basic completion dropdown using the Enter key, square will be inserted where the caret is. This is not what we want. We want to replace the string type. So instead, we need to use Tab to select the item we want, and this will replace the text that's in front of the caret. We can use Tab to replace the variable name with a new suggestion as well. We saw earlier how the complete statement feature can be used to put a semicolon on the end of an unfinished line. We can use this feature for other things too. If we type 4 and then use complete statement, IntelliJ IDEA will insert the round brackets and curly braces needed for a for loop and place the caret inside the brackets. We can then use IntelliJ IDEA suggestions to fill in the for loop values, and smart completion will choose the only iterable available in this context. Pressing Shift, Command and Enter, or Control, Shift and Enter again, will put our caret into the body of the for loop. We can use complete current statement to create a valid if statement as well. Let's check something in square 1. If we select a method suggestion using Control and dot, the method call will be added to our code followed by a dot. We can use this if we know we're going to chain method calls. Let's select isBlank here. Now, What we want is to do something if the ID is not blank. Instead of having to move the caret all the way to the start of the expression to type an exclamation mark to negate this statement, we can simply type dot not to use postfix completion to negate this expression. There's a whole range of postfix completion templates. For example, we could get the ID of this square object and use dot sout to wrap the expression in a system.out.println to output this to the console. To see all the postfix options on a symbol, type a dot and then press the up arrow to browse the completion dropdown. Now we've seen and used all the main code completion techniques. Let's finish up by taking a quick look at some other areas of code completion that might be useful. HIPI completion analyzes text from all parts of any open files. We can use Alt and forward slash to have IntelliJ IDEA suggest any matching value from the file. This might be most useful when we're creating or reusing text values. Code completion isn't just for Java code. Code completion is available for all languages that IntelliJ Platform IDEs support. And while we might expect code completion inside files for each language type, IntelliJ IDEA can use this power even inside string values in, for example, a Java class. We tell IntelliJ IDEA that a particular string contains a particular language, and we'll get code suggestions and completion inside this string value. We also get help when writing HTML or XML files, such as suggestions and completion. That was an overview of the code completion features available in IntelliJ IDEA. Thanks for watching.